There's a lot going on in the world today. Our hearts go out to the French people, for the tragedy that happened over there. And, darkness is continuing to increase in this world. And a lot of people don't realize that that's exactly what the word says will happen, that there will be perilous times, that the hearts of people will grow cold. And I could go on, and we will look at a lot of those verses as we delve deeper into the days that we're living in. But today, I just want to tell you that all of this, and I think that even people that aren't aware that Jesus is coming back, understand that something is building, that there's something on the horizon that's coming, and they can't put their finger on it. Maybe that's where you are today. But our world is exponentially spinning out of control. But it's really not, because it's in the hand of the Lord. This is what God said would happen. He is allowing it to happen, and it's pointing to the return of Jesus. Now, the return of Jesus, the Lord got my attention many years ago, and I'll explain what happened probably next week sometime. If you've looked at the preparing for his coming videos that I've done, you'll already know what I'm talking about here. But the Lord got my attention about 17, 18 years ago, and really woke me up to the fact that Jesus is coming back, and I need to be ready for him. I need to be living for that moment. And in that time frame since then, I have realized that the enemy has done a masterful job in deceiving people, into making people think that this is a waste of time to look into, to study, and to prepare for. But it's not. And I'm going to show you how it's not. And we're going to be looking probably over the next week or so. And then I'm going to try to intersperse a little bit of what's coming with just daily devotionals like I have been doing to help you in your daily walk. But today, there's a verse out of Ezekiel chapter 33, verse 6. It says, "But if the watchman sees the sword coming and does not blow the trumpet, and the people are not warned, and the sword comes and takes any person from among them, he is taken away in his iniquity, but his blood I will require at the watchman's hand. So you, son of man, I have made you a watchman for the house of Israel. Therefore you shall hear a word from me, from my mouth, and warn them for me." Now, I've already told you that my name means the courteous watchman. And as I've said before also, if you know me, that's a pretty fitting name. I have become what my name means. I take my job as a watchman very seriously, not because my name means watchman, because the Lord told me, "Curtis, you are a watchman." And part of that means to say, "Curtis, I want you to prepare people for what's coming." Now, there's a lot that's coming, and there's a lot that I have on my heart. This is one of my passions. Spiritual warfare is one of them, and of course, making people get to the place where they're whole, body, soul, and spirit is another. But this is one of the big ones as well, and that's that Jesus is coming back soon. And as a watchman, I bear a great responsibility for sharing the dangers that are awake, the signs that we need to be looking for. And I encourage you, don't write this stuff off. Listen to me, because I believe that I can prove from the Word the days that we're living in and the signs that we're supposed to be looking for. What I want to leave you with today is, are you living as a light in the darkness? And if you're called to be a watchman, are you sounding the alarm? Because I can't be quiet about this, because he says, as a watchman, the responsibility is on you if you fail to warn them. So my warning is beginning today. It's been in various other ways, but through these devotionals, it really begins today to say, it's time to wake up, because we've got some difficult times coming. I don't say that to be pessimistic or negative. I say that to be realistic and to say, this is what I believe the Lord has said through his word and through what he's spoken to me personally. Now, you don't need to take what he's spoken to me personally as the word of the Lord unless you know me, for one thing, unless you test it, and as long as it lines up with the word is what the word is saying. That's what we've got to do with anyone who is speaking as if the Lord is talking through them today. Today, I pray that you hear the watchman's cry, that you begin to prepare and live for that moment. Tomorrow, we're going to look at a verse in Romans that I pray will wake you up. Today, remember, Jesus is coming back soon. God is on the throne. He's the one that's ultimately in control. We don't need to fear what's coming. In fact, we need to embrace it with faith, understanding the times that we're living in, and look forward to what God is going to do through us during those times. I pray your day is full of blessings and that the Lord speaks to you and brings revelation to you today about the coming of His Son, Jesus.